Welcome back to Respond.io. So you have learned how to set up auto assignment workflows from our previous video. Now we'll show you how to design routing workflows for multiple teams. For companies with multiple customer-facing teams, effectively routing conversations to the right team is challenging. But with the right strategy, routing can improve the quality of customer conversations. Unlike traditional email tickets, customers expect immediate replies with messaging. However, chat routing for IM allows automating questions without human intervention, speeding up the process of routing to the right team and increasing conversation satisfaction. Every company works differently, so there are many ways to design an optimal routing workflow. Here are some common strategies your business can use. 1. Route to teams with specific functions such as sales, support, finance, and so on. 2. Routing based on business hours for companies with more than one shift. 3. Language-based routing ensures contacts get support in their preferred language. Remember, you can use these strategies individually or together to create a simpler or more complex routing workflow depending on your business needs. Let me first show you an example of a simple routing method. It includes creating an ask a question step to understand the conversation purpose so we can route the conversation to the right team based on functions, then adding the date and time step into the workflow for teams with multiple shifts. When a contact starts a conversation, we want to ask a question, save the answers, and use them as conditions in a branch. Here's how you can design the workflow. Set up the conversation open trigger as shown in our previous video. Click on the plus node and choose Ask a Question. Rename the step and state your question in the text field. Then select multiple choice as your question type and list down your answer choices. Mine will be sales and support. So when the question is triggered, the contact can choose the team they wish to speak to. Then save their answer as a variable. A variable stores data to be used in other steps within the workflow. Let's give it a relevant name. In this case, conversation_purpose. Now the answers are saved, we can use the variable to configure the next branch step. Click on the plus node and select branch, and I'll rename this route to team. Under branch 1, we'll set the conditions to variable, the variable name is equal to sales. So when contacts choose to speak to sales, the conversations will fall on this branch. We'll add a second branch and configure the conditions similar to branch 1, but this time I'll change the value to support. This way, when contacts choose support, the conversations will fall on branch 2. Then, to assign contacts conversation to a user, apply the auto assignment strategies from previous video at the end of each branch. If your company provides 24-hour assistance with two or more support teams on rotation, you can add steps to route conversations to specific teams on shift throughout the day. For example, if I have three support teams in my company, this is how I'll design the workflow. Click on the plus node and select date and time. Rename the step and set the conditions to business hours is within, and configure the first shift's working hours and time zone. Under the success branch, create an assign to step with team shift A selected. This way, if the message comes in between 12 a.m. and 7:59 a.m., the contact will be assigned to an agent from the support team in shift A. Under the failure branch, I've created similar steps but with different business hours and team shifts. So support team B and C will receive messages sent during their working hours. Branches can be extremely powerful when used with multiple conditions. This is known as complex routing. Don't worry, we have an example, and this includes creating a complex routing workflow using language-based routing strategy. Additionally, we'll be showing steps you can add to the workflow to prevent losing conversations when routing fails. Let's start by creating a language-based routing workflow. This is great for companies with international customers as the workflow can route chats to agents who speak their contact's native language. Using the same question and variable from our previous workflow, let's make branch 1 the English-speaking sales team. We'll start by configuring the first condition to the sales variable as we did before. Then add a new condition with the following settings. Contact field language is equal to English. So when a contact opens a new conversation and wishes to speak to sales with the presumption of knowing the contact's preferred language as English from a previous conversation, the message will go down the English sales route. Here's what the final workflow should look like. We have four branches in total with two conditions each, making this a multi-condition branching workflow. But what if the routing fails? It may happen due to unexpected or missing data. In that event, we'll route the chat down to the else branch. The simplest setup is to create a comment step, add a brief description explaining the issue, and assign the contact to a supervisor. These are just some examples of what you can do with workflows. If you're interested to know more but are not already on our platform, click on the link down below to sign up for a free Respond.io account. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below. Thanks so much for watching, and don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe to Respond.io for all things business messaging.